Hi guys, welcome back to Weld.com. I'm Mikala and today I'm going to be showing you the difference between pulsed and non-pulsed TIG welding. I'm using my Miller Destiny TIG plant with pure argon shielding gas. I've got my TIG machine set at 120 amps and on an AC current as I'm welding aluminium. In my TIG torch I have a 2.4mm lanthanated tungsten with 2.4mm ESAB 4043 aluminium filler rod. I'm using an edge glass cup for better viewing of the arc. Firstly, using no pulse means there is a consistent current. So whatever your amps are set at, like mine are set at 120, that is what will come out of the torch consistently. This creates a soft weld and is really easy to add filler to. All the welds I'm doing today, I'm using an open corner joint, as this is the easiest way to see the difference between pulsed and non-pulsed TIG welding. Some of the reasons we use pulse welding is for when we're welding in difficult positions, such as overhead. When gravity works against you, pulse welding can help keep the whirlpool above you. It can also be used to help achieve that laying down dimes effect, as it creates a consistent weld, as long as your travel speed's the same all the way along. And it can also be used to go over ugly welds to make them look nicer. With pulse welding, you operate your TIG machine exactly how you would before. The only difference is a pulsed waveform will come out of the torch instead of a consistent one. You use your foot pedal exactly the same as you would. For example, backing off means less heat, pushing down on the pedal heats it up more. The first pulse setting I'm going to show you is 1 pulse per second. I'm going to tack it together in an open corner joint and then fully weld it with no filler material. All my welds today I'm using 120 peak amps and this drops down to 30 amps whilst pulsing. This is what the 1 pulse per second weld looks like. They're quite wide beads, but it does create a nice consistent weld. Now I'm going to try it with the pulse per second set at 2.5. This is the 2.5 pulse per second weld. As you can see, it's nice and consistent. With the 1 pulse per second and the 2.5 pulse per second, these you can add filler rod to really easily, as you can time when you're going to add it. But anything faster than 2.5 becomes quite hard to add filler rod to. When using 1 pulse per second, you can time when to add the filler rod, like this. This is one pulse per second with filler rod. And this is two pulses per second with filler rod. I'm now going to turn it up from 2.5 to 10 and see how much a difference it makes. Pulses per second is a lot faster and harder to add filler wire to, but it has created a nice consistent weld. I've now changed the PPS to 100. When welding one pulse per second or 2.5 pulses per second, you can time it just right to add your filler rod. When you go higher than 2.5 pulses per second, it's much harder to add filler rod to. If your TIG machine doesn't have a pulse setting, then not to worry, you can use your foot pedal to pulse. This is called manual pulsing. When manually welding, I put my foot flat to the floor to get 120 amps, then I lift it up almost all the way but not off, and repeat this process to create a pulse. When manually pulse welding, you're never going to get the same consistency as you would with a proper pulse setting on a TIG machine, but it still does the trick of making nice welds. Here we have all the different welds I've done today. We have no pulse, which is a very smooth weld and you can't see any dimes in it. This was a consistent current at 120 amps. We then have the one pulse per second, which create very long dimes, but create a consistent weld. We then have 2.5 pulses per second, which is my favourite. This creates the laying dimes effect and looks really good. We then have the 10 pulses per second, where it's harder to see the dimes and is getting more like a consistent weld. We then have the 100 pulse per second, which looks like a consistent weld but is pulsed. It creates a slightly thinner weld than the consistent non-pulsed. And finally, we have the manually pulsed. The manually pulsed is never going to be as consistent as it would on a proper pulse TIG setting, but it does the job of creating a neat weld. Ta-da! That's all from me. I hope you enjoyed the video and thank you so much for watching.